So now that the engine is winter ready, I like to continue with the doors, since there's still an open gap there. So let's make some space because they are behind the trailer there, and let's get them in the workshop. So the nice thing about these doors from the ambulance is that they have an overhead roof, and that means the water cannot go straight from above into the door tops and into the door bottoms, which will cause them to rust. Especially the door tops, after 40 or 50 years they are prone to be rusting badly, especially in those corners where the water collects. Same goes for the door bottoms. Almost all the Land Rovers have problems with the door bottoms. That's because the water from the top goes down into those profiles and collects at the bottom. In those bottoms the water cannot escape. They only fill the small drain holes, which you can see here, but over time they get clogged. But due to this overhead roof of the ambulance, they are still rock solid. So first I like to separate the tops from the bottom. That makes working a little bit easier on them, since they are kind of heavy on the top. These plugs were installed to inject some wax oil inside the door tops. This was done by the Dutch military, which is actually a kind of good idea. I'm taking it out so it's easy to sand the door tops, and afterwards I will paint this stuff green, and once the paint is dry I will put the plugs back. the doors are now completely stripped. We ended up with these door locks, the shifters from the other window locks, also these guide pins, or these guide shafts from the doors. So this panel I removed from the passenger door. It is to store your charts and other papers. And once I took it off, I found this rubber. It was laying on the bottom there. Nobody could ever reach it, but I think it was placed here on top like a protection. Also, I found this old parking ticket. So next job is to sandblast all these parts and repaint it. And these parts should be galvanized. These door tops are also galvanized. I will try to get the paint off by using paint stripper. These strips are made of aluminium. I can just scratch off the paint and then sandblast them afterwards. So yeah, so the tops and the bottom door parts are now laying outside. And I need to clean them and then sand them afterwards. And then put some paint in them and put them back together. So the door bottoms have now been sanded, and now I will apply some special primer. This primer will stabilize the existing rust. These bulkhead bolts can be really stuck, so that's why I'm putting some copper slip on them. So when the hinges are on, you can put back the mirrors. So now that the door is in, it's time to place the weather strip. This strip is between the door bottom and the door top, and it prevents water from getting inside. As you can see, they are way too long, so you need to trim them down according to the right length. So now that the weather strip is lined up and trimmed to the right length, it's time to put back the door top. Now that the front of the car is finished, it's time to move to the back. And as you can see, I already took out the window frames and the hatches. I will restore the window frames in the next video. And I also will show you how I took them out, since that one is still inside. The body needs to be gray as well, so it will take a while to sand this whole area. Also the back of the car, you have those two big doors. They also need to be sanded down and painted, of course.